Hello friends, welcome again in online sessions of oil hydraulic and pneumatic. In today's session, we will discuss about the remaining hydraulic fluids, contaminants and additives. What is different types of hydraulic fluid, what is requirement and how to remove the contaminants and what is additive. So let's start our session. In previous lecture, we have also discussed about the different types of hydraulic fluid, as like the mineral oil, or as a water as a hydraulic fluid, or different types of biodegradable and vegetables oil. So next hydraulic fluid is fire resistance hydraulic fluid. First of all, what is requirement of fire resistance fluid? Because hydraulic system operate at a different location and different application. Example, if you want to design hydraulic system for particular as like the coal mine or hot metal processing equipments or aircraft or marine fluid, power system, or as like the in mining industry. So we have to operate the hydraulic system at a higher temperature. So that hydraulic system used for fire resistance hydraulic fluid. And it is developed to reduce the fire hazard. So it is special application for hydraulic system and can be ignited but doesn't support the combustion when the ignition source is remove. So it is a major advantages of hydraulic fluid compared to the other as like the mineral, water, biodegradable and vegetables oils. Now we will discuss about the types of fire resistance fluid. There are the mainly four types of fire resistance fluid. First one is water glycol solution, second one is straight synthetic, third one is water in oil emulsion, and fourth one is high water content fluid, or it's called HWCFS, means high water content fluid. Now we will discuss in detail. First fire resistance fluid is water glycol solution, means 50% water and 50% glycol. So it's called high water content fluid. In proportional is 1:1. It has a high viscosity index compared to the water and vegetable oil, and its operating temperature is -20 degree to 85 degree centigrade. So we can easily operate at a lower temperature. Example, if you want to design hydraulic system for foreign countries, that's the temperature in -degree. So we can also operate there, and we can also operate at a up to 85 degree centigrade temperature. So it is advantageous compared to the other fluid. Next one is straight synthetics, means it is chemically formulated inhibitor combustion, and it is also used for at a higher temperature operations of hydraulic system. It has a higher fire resistance temperature compared to the water glycol solution, and disadvantage is only for low viscosity index. It is incompatible with most natural or synthetic rubber seal and high cost. So it will be react with the rubber seal. So you cannot utilize the rubber seal with this type of hydraulic fluid. Third one, fire resistance fluid is water in oil emulsion, means maximum quantity of water will be 40% and 60% will be oil. So it has a higher lubricant properties compared to the water glycol solution, and its operating temperature is -30 degree centigrade to the 80 degree centigrade. Fourth one of fire resistance fluid is high water content fluid. It's called HWCFS, means it contains the 90% water and 10% additive. So it's called high water content fluid, means it contains the maximum quantity of water and minimum quantity of the additives. And additives used for improve the performance of this type of hydraulic fluids. And additives will be improve the viscosity, lubrication, rust protection, and protection against the bacteria growth. So additives you should utilize. And maximum operating temperature should be held to the 50 degree centigrade and minimum evaporation, because in this type of fluid contain the maximum quantity of water. So it will be not operate the higher temperature. At a higher temperature or above the 50 degree centigrade, water will be start to evaporation, and it is the disadvantages of high water content fluid. Now we will discuss about the advantages and disadvantages of high water content fluid. Main advantages of high water content fluid, it is fire resistant, because we are utilizing maximum quantity of water, as like the 90% water, and its flash point is near to the 150 degree centigrade, and low system operating temperature due to the heat dissipation, because the maximum quantity of water utilization, so there will be a maximum heat dissipation capacity, and it is biodegradable because 90% using water, and environmental friendly because we are using maximum quantity of water. Then after that, it is high viscosity index, clean operations of system because the maximum quantity of water utilization, and low cost of concentration and storage, because if there will be some amount of leakage, so we can also easily fill this type of leakage by adding some amount of water, or up to the 90% of water. Now we will discuss about the disadvantages of fire resistant fluid, as like the high water content fluid. So there is some disadvantages. First disadvantages of fire resistant fluid, as like the high water content fluid, is high evaporation losses, because we are using maximum quantity of water, so there will be maximum evaporation losses, and faster corrosion due to the oxidation, because there is the maximum quantity of water present, so it is corrosive in nature, so there will be maximum quantity of the oxidation and corrosion. You should maintain the pH value up to 7.5 to the 9. You have to compulsory maintain this pH value, and greater contamination due to the higher density of fluid, so there will be maximum quantity of contamination, and promotion of bacteria growth, because we are using water quantity, so there will be maximum growth of bacteria, and filtration difficulty due to the acidic natures of fluid, so there will be some difficulty regarding to the filtrations of high water content fluid. Now we will discuss about the contaminants, or what is contaminants, or what is source of contaminants, or how we can remove the contamination. The first of all, definitions of contaminants. It is various type of contaminants occurs in fluid power system. Contaminants means it is one types of impurities. It can be created during the production, during the transportation, during the maintenance, or during the operation. There is the basically three types of contaminants: gaseous, liquid, and solid contaminants. Gaseous contaminants as like the air, liquid contaminants as like the water, or solid contaminants as like the emery, metal, scale, rust, particles, etc. So these are the many solid particle contaminants, and it will be continuously flow throughout the system, and it will be decrease the whole system efficiency. So we should remove the contaminants from the system by utilizations, or by operations, or by maintenance, or by different processes. This is also a diagram which type of contaminants and how can it be, can be removed. Now we will discuss about the source of contaminants. First source of contaminants is during the production. If you are preparing the hydraulic fluid for special application or special purposes, so during it can be possibility to the contaminants. So you should care about the during the productions of hydraulic fluid. Second contaminant is during the storage. If you store the hydraulic fluid for long duration or for short duration, so it can be chances of contamination. Here show the diagram contaminant and without contaminant. In this tank without contaminant or protected, there will be no suspended particle. While in contaminant type storage tank, there is the many types of contaminants, as like the gaseous form, as like the in liquid form, or in solid particle or suspended particle. Third one is contaminant during the fluid transport. It is chances to contaminants during the transportation from one place to the another place, or during the cleaning process. Next one is inbuilt contaminant hydraulic fluid during the production, or due to the natures of hydraulic fluid, it can be chances to the inbuilt hydraulic fluid contamination. And last source of contamination is during the maintenance. If you operate the hydraulic system for long durations of time, so you should maintain the hydraulic system. And during the maintenance, it is chances to be sources of contaminants. So you should care about during the maintenance. This is also a diagram of different types of contaminants, solid, liquid, gaseous, as like the suspended particle, solid particle, or there are the many contaminants during the operation, process, transportation, storage, and during life cycles of system. Now we will discuss about the effect of contaminants. What is effect on hydraulic system? First effect is about the accelerate to wears of system components, because there is the some solid particle suspended in hydraulic fluid. So it will be create the wear out of mating component or component between the relative motion, as like the control valve in hydraulic system, bearing in which fatigue wears during the hydraulic system, gears during the lubrication system, as like the in pump, hydraulic and lubrication system. So this is the effect on contaminants during the operations of system due to the wear of component. Second is abrasive wear effect. It will be change the dimensional changes of mating component. It will be create the leakage of hydraulic fluid and decrease the efficiency of hydraulic pump and generated the wear and more wear. If you not remove the contaminants from system, so it will be continuously wear out and more wear during the operations of cycle. Third is typically component subject to the wear, abrasive wear, as like the typical component used in hydraulic system is like the pump, motor, spool valve and cylinder. So there are the many typical component used in hydraulic system and it will be abrasive wear out due to the contaminants. Now we will discuss about the additives. First of all, what is additive? Additive is used for the improve the properties of hydraulic fluid, because the during the production or during the preparations of hydraulic fluid, we have not met the all our required properties. So we have to improve the performance of hydraulic fluid. Let's take one example. If I want to utilize the water as a hydraulic fluid, but water is a corrosive nature or it has a non-lubricant property, so I have to add some additives. It will be improve the performance of water. So this is the important of additives, and additives will be always improve the performance of hydraulic system, as like the increase the flash point temperature, or it will be becomes a fire resistant fluid, or it will be increase the different properties. As like the first property is anti-wear additives. Anti-wear additives will be reduce the friction or wear out between the mating part of hydraulic system components. So anti-wear additives will be improve the or reduce the component wear out and friction. Second one is anti-forming additives. Due to the continuous operation or due to the combinations of different contaminants, as like the solid, liquid and gaseous, there will be creations of forming. So anti-wear forming will be reduce the formations of fluid. Next one is corrosive inhibitor. It will be reduce the corrosion, because we are using different types of emulsions of fluid for different system purposes. So it will be reduce the corrosions of hydraulic system. Next one is about oxidation inhibitor. Means it will be reduce the oxidation. Due to the operation, air will be always come in contact with the hydraulic fluid. So it will be reduce the oxidation, because we are using different emulsions. Next one is emulsifying agent. It will be continuously maintain the emulsion and disemulsion properties of hydraulic fluid according to the requirement. Next one is deionization agent. It will be also one types of chemical reacting component or additives, and it will be improve the performance of hydraulic fluid. And next is anti-vaporizing agent, because we are using in many types of hydraulic fluid as a water emulsion, so we should maintain the vaporization agent, and it will be increase the evaporative temperatures of hydraulic fluid. Thank you for watching all these types of hydraulic fluid, different types of contaminants and additives used in hydraulic system. Thank you.